Welcome back, everyone. In this screencast, we're going to discuss chloroplasts, pigments, and photosystems in order to continue our study of photosynthesis. Remember, whenever we talk about photosynthesis, we're referring to the process where we take photons of light, carbon dioxide, and water, and put them through a series of chemical reactions inside the chloroplasts of a plant's cells. We then create glucose and oxygen. If we zoom in even more on photosynthesis, yet again we'll recall that there are two separate components to photosynthesis, the light-dependent reactions and the light-independent reactions. The light-dependent reactions are triggered by photons of light released from the sun, whereas the light-independent reactions are not triggered by photons of light. Don't forget that all of this takes place within the chloroplast. The light-independent reactions take place out in the middle of the chloroplast in an area called the stroma, but the light-dependent reactions take place inside a special series of compartments, which we're going to learn about later in this screencast. Let's start by taking a look at the structure of a chloroplast. Chloroplasts are organelles that are found in plant cells, and this is where photosynthesis takes place. Remember that organelles are significantly smaller than cells. Chloroplasts are surrounded by two membranes. If we were to zoom in on these two membranes, they would look just like our old friend, the phospholipid bilayer. A chloroplast has two layers of membranes, one on the outside and one on the inside. The two membranes surrounding chloroplasts are called the outer and inner membranes, and the space in between them is called the lumen. Chloroplasts are highly complex, but one of the most important structures inside the chloroplast is something called the thylakoid. Thylakoids, there are actually many of them in chloroplasts, are the sites of the light-dependent reactions, which is the first section of photosynthesis. If we look more closely at the thylakoid, we'll notice that it is also made up of two membranes, and this space right in the center is once again called the lumen. There isn't just one thylakoid inside a chloroplast. That would be really inefficient to only have one site for the light-dependent reactions. There are actually stacks of thylakoids spaced throughout the chloroplast. Each one of these stacks of thylakoids is called a granum. If you have more than one granum, we call them grana, and they're connected together by a structure called lamellae, which is essentially a large membrane containing more chlorophyll. The area inside the chloroplast that is not part of the thylakoids, the grana, or the lamellae is called the stroma. Don't forget that the thylakoids are the sites of the light-dependent reactions, whereas the stroma is the site of the light-independent reactions. So somehow, the products of the light-dependent reactions are going to need to exit the thylakoids and enter the stroma in order for the second part of photosynthesis to occur. We've now discussed chloroplasts, and so we're going to move on to our second two topics, which are both interconnected within the chloroplast. We're going to discuss pigments and photosystems, both of which have to do with the light-dependent reactions. So they're going to be dealing with the first part of photosynthesis. If we look back at this diagram, we now know that the light-dependent reactions are taking place in the thylakoids. However, we need to somehow get the energy out of the photons of light and put them into the chloroplast. And the next two topics are going to explain how this works. To discuss both pigments and photosystems, we're going to take a look at how the thylakoid is responsible for absorbing energy from the sun. The sun releases energy in the form of particles called photons. Photons of light are not a form of energy that the chloroplast can absorb directly. The photons must be absorbed by a pigment contained within a photosystem. So we're going to zoom in on the edge of the thylakoid a little bit. Okay, so now that we've zoomed in on the edge of the thylakoid a little bit more, we can see how the photon transfers energy to the chloroplast. So what I've drawn here, this funnel shape that looks kind of like a stentor, is something called a photosystem. And what it is a series of proteins and lipids that helps to transfer the energy into a form that the plant can actually use. Inside this funnel that we call a photosystem are things called pigments, for instance, chlorophyll, which is that green stuff that you get if you take a really big fall on grass. There are many different kinds of pigments, all of which absorb different wavelengths of light. But this particular pigment is going to be called P680. P for pigment and 680 for the wavelength of the light in nanometers. The photon contains a large amount of energy, and when it makes contact with the photosystem, like this, it's going to transfer the energy to the pigments surrounding it. All of the pigment molecules inside the photosystem are going to get excited by the contact with the photon. When all of the pigments have been excited, it culminates in the release of a high-energy electron. Now, a high-energy electron doesn't sound particularly powerful, but when it runs through something called an electron transport chain, it generates a pretty sizable amount of energy. We'll be discussing this electron transport chain later on this week.